and symptoms of mono. While the correct medical term is infectious mononucleosis, most everyone refers to this illness as mono, or the kissing disease. The condition results from the Epstein-Barr virus, EBV, and can be passed on through the mouth, via saliva. This is where the kissing disease concept originated from. As such, the illness is known to affect many a teenager. But it can also be passed on by sharing drinks and food with people. Mono is not a fatal condition, however it is one that can leave those who contracted it quite sick, weak, and very uncomfortable. In some instances, the illness can further progress into other conditions, including tonsillitis, strep throat, and some have even developed a sinus infection due to mono. Additionally, while quite uncommon though, mono has even progressed into serious, more severe conditions like heart inflammation, thrombocytopenia, anemia, difficulties around the nervous system, Guillain-Barré syndrome, meningitis, and there have been cases where individuals experience an obstruction in their breathing due to extremely swollen tonsils. The good news is, mono will eventually leave a person's system in about 1 to 2 months' time. The bad news is, if you've contracted mono, there is no cure or treatment for recovery. Still, if you think you have mono, it is a good idea to visit your family doctor. First and foremost, they can determine whether or not you do, in fact, have mono, as the illness does share various related symptoms that can be connected to other conditions, provide some advice to help with recovery, and assist with easing your symptoms. As this kissing disease can be quite painful. So, what should you be looking out for when it comes to mono? Here are the top 10 signs and symptoms of infectious mononucleosis. One. Sore throat. More than just a sore throat that comes with a cold, the sore throat one experiences when they have infectious mononucleosis can be severe. It may be difficult to drink, eat, or even swallow your own spit. What separates mono from a cold is the fact that you will not have any other symptoms associated with a cold, other than that sore throat factor. No sneezing, no coughing, no runny nose. 2. Fever. As will any infection, a fever will be one of the very first symptoms that pop up when someone contracts the kissing disease. Should an individual have a fever for more than 10 days, it is highly recommended to visit a physician as soon as possible. While you could very well have mono, a fever that does not go away in 10 or so days is a very huge indicator that something is wrong with your body that needs to be assessed. Mono or not. 3. Swollen lymph nodes. Lymph nodes are part of a person's lymphatic system, and are comprised up of a clear liquid that streams throughout the body. Made up of white blood cells that attack bacteria, lymph nodes tend to swell when one is infected with mono. In general, the monovirus causes an individual to create more white blood cells, thus causing your lymph nodes to swell. Lymph nodes located in your groin area, armpits and neck. So those that suffer with this illness will notice these areas swollen while sick with condition. Regardless, if you notice swollen lymph nodes, it is important to visit the doctor as soon as possible. While what you have could be mono, this symptom could also be a sign of something more serious, HIV, or cancer. 4. Swollen tonsils. Speaking of swollen, another area in the body that swells up when having infectious mononucleosis is your tonsils, making it that much harder to eat or drink. Swollen tonsils have a tendency to hurt pretty badly, so definitely seek help as soon as possible. As mentioned above, there are times when tonsil can swell up so badly, a person's breathing can be impaired. It is vital to seek medical attention if this occurs. 5. Fatigue. The fever, lack of fluids, and food can cause an individual with mono to experience high levels of fatigue. It almost feels like no amount of rest can help when it comes to energy or wanting to do anything but lie in bed. However, that may be a good thing, as most doctors will advise those with mono to simply take some time off of work or school and rest up as much as possible. Six. Muscle aches. Those who have infectious mononucleosis will often complain about sore and achy muscles. This is a result, once again, of other symptoms like fever, fatigue, as well as lack of fluids and food due to the illness. Lots of rest and fluids and some ibuprofen can help with this symptom. 7. Skin rashes. Unfortunately, at times mono can be misdiagnosed as strep throat or other throat or mouth infections, and there are times when doctors will prescribe amoxicillin or other antibiotics to their patients to help clear their illness up. Sometimes when this happens, a mono sufferer will break out in a rash on their body or face days later. The rash will resemble the measles and be quite itchy. 8. Headaches. Another painful symptom of this illness are headaches that will reoccur until the infectious mononucleosis is cleared. Still, it's important to note that a rash, CPR slide, along with headaches are also signs of meningitis, an illness that rarely results from mono, but can develop from the condition. Therefore, it is always important to reach out to a doctor, should you be concerned about these symptoms, if they go hand in hand. 9. Red spots. Those with mono tend to notice small, red-colored spots, or areas that resemble bruises inside their mouth or the roof of their mouth. They may be painful and add to the difficulty of eating foods and drinking fluids. As such, a doctor may recommend an ibuprofen to help ease the pain while you are recovering from mono. This will not only help you feel more comfortable, but also help with fluid intake. 10. Sore abdomen. While it is rare, from time to time, individuals with mono will experience soreness in their upper abdomen due to a swollen spleen, an illness that can develop thanks to infectious mononucleosis. This can evolve approximately 4 to 21 days after a person begins to notice their initial mono signs or symptoms. Another sign that could point to a ruptured spleen, and therefore point to mono, includes developing jaundice, which would create a yellowish tinge on one's body, face, and eyes.